Newkirk, Dale Earnhardt Jr., the newest member of our NBC NASCAR broadcast team. Newgate for Jr., but he's still the same guy that fans love, and he gets things going July 1st from Chicagoland. Jr. brings us to today's top five Pocono moments and one of his most memorable wins. Let's take a look at those if we can. And Kyle, we'll start with number five from June of 2014. Brad Keselowski tried to use Danica Patrick's car to get rid of some debris, but when he slowed down, Jr. caught him, passed him, went on to win.
Yeah, I'm not sure that there was shifting going on during that race, but Brad took his brain and knocked it in neutral one at turn one right there. I don't know what that was all about. But basically, just pulled out of the way and gave Junior that win.
Number four, in the first race after the repave in 2012, this is sliced bread Joey Logano getting into the back of the van who gave him that nickname, Mark Martin.
You know, and listen, this is a big race for me. I feel like this is a race that Joey Logano began to come into his own. He didn't back down from anybody. If you don't back down from Mark Martin, you're not backing down from anyone.
True enough. Number three, August 2015, fuel woes wreaking havoc on the leaders for the final lap. Matt Kenseth coming out on top.
Yeah, Matt Kenseth coming out on top. The only person more surprised than Matt Kenseth was his wife, Katie, and his kids, who were already going to the airport because they figured no way he's going to win this thing.
Number two, 1986. This is Tip Richmond in the 25 on the outside, passing Jeff Bodine in the 5 car for the lead on the final turn of the final lap. And Ricky Rumpy and 3 wide on the inside.
Listen, for all you fans that are just fans over the last 8 or 10 years and don't remember this type of racing or this move at this racetrack, and that had everyone scratching their head. Tim Richmond was such a talent to pass on the outside on that last lap. It was an incredible move.
And you know this one was going to be in there. June of 2000, tables turned on the Intimidator. Jeremy Mayfield knocking Dale Earnhardt out of the way on the final turn of the final lap to win.
Yes, Jeremy Mayfield did not get the book that you're not supposed to run into the 3 car, and obviously he ran into him and knocked him out of the way. And that was a big moment. I'm telling